The college basketball season is almost upon us, and we're just a couple of weeks away from teams playing their opening games. One team I'm a huge fan of watching is UConn, as their young team, led by superstar talent Paige Bueckers, is an amazingly fun team to watch. After reaching the Final Four last season, the squad looks ready to run it back, and, in my opinion, should see some improvements in 2022, potentially going all the way to win it all. In today's video, I'll be taking a look at the UConn Huskies roster for the 2022 season, how they stack up against other top-tier schools, and overall, why I believe, at least in the preseason, they look primed for a championship run come the madness in March. Before we start, if you're new here and enjoy the video, be sure to subscribe for more basketball content like this. I'd love to hit 100 subscribers, so all support would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, with that being said, let's talk about the UConn Huskies. Firstly, let's dissect this Huskies roster and why they look so dangerous on paper right now. We obviously have to talk about Paige Bueckers. Bueckers is arguably the best player in college basketball right now, and even as just a sophomore, has the capability to carry the Huskies team to a national championship. She was absolutely dominant last season and earned all the awards that she received, averaging 21 points, 5 assists and 5 rebounds on amazing shooting splits of over 50% from the field and 3-point territory. It was a historic season for the freshman, and after the heartbreak of the 2021 Final Four, you already know she's going to be determined to get back to the top in 2022. I could go on all day about Paige Bueckers and her game, how she makes her teammates better, how she drastically changes the dynamic of UConn's offense. But that would make this video too long, and obviously, this video isn't just about her. For a deeper analysis on Paige Bueckers' game and an insight into the details of her play, be sure to watch my play analysis I made on her a few months ago. I'll be sure to link it at the end of the video for you all. But again, with that said, Paige Bueckers is a truly special talent and one that could be absolutely transcendent in the game of women's basketball. If UConn are going to have any success next season, Paige will no doubt be a part of that. I can't wait to watch her play again and tear it up next season, as she undoubtedly leads UConn to enormous success. Another sophomore that I really like on UConn going into 2022 is Nika Mule. Mule doesn't dominate the stat sheet quite like Paige or make the same impact, but she certainly makes her presence known in the minutes that she plays. Mule is a spark plug for the Huskies, a high-energy player who's able to make momentum-swinging plays for the team. She's a hard-working player, always hustling on both ends of the floor, and she's also proven she can shoot the ball decently too. Her 3-point percentage rose greatly in the second half of the season last year, once she had settled into UConn's system. My favourite game that I've seen from Nika Mule certainly has to be the regular season matchup against South Carolina last season. Though Bueckers stole the show with a crazy dagger, Nika's heart and effort to begin the game is what gave the Huskies energy after a slow start offensively. She picked up multiple charges drawn against South Carolina, giving them no momentum to run with, while UConn was still getting in their groove. She was constantly making big plays, and that energy is something UConn will love to have next season. Again, Mule's impact isn't always in the stat sheet, but if you watch the games, you'll know how large of a presence she has whenever she steps onto the court. Some other players that I really like on this squad are some of the seniors, like Olivia Nelson-Adoda, Kristen Williams, and Aaliyah Edwards. These players are all dependable on all areas of the court. Edwards and Nelson-Adoda are great inside players who have begun stretching the floor in recent seasons a bit more, and Bueckers was able to find them inside on many occasions during last season. Their defensive presence inside is also key, as, for example, they clamped up Baylor down the stretch of that brilliant Elite Eight matchup. With more experience with Bueckers, the pick and roll sequences with those three are going to be deadly and presumably a key part of the Huskies' offense this season. In a season where there was often a lack of consistency from second option players offensively behind Paige, Kristen Williams was often the player to step up and fill that scoring role. Though sometimes inconsistent herself, Williams' shooting touch was a must-have at many points during the season and added to the versatility to UConn's attack. Bueckers was doubled multiple times off-ball last season and guarded very tightly by opposition. When she wasn't free, other players had to free up and hit shots, and Williams played her part in that role beautifully. In now her final season at UConn, expect plenty of Williams' touches during next season. I think a stat line of 17 points, 4 rebounds and 3 assists on something like 45% from the field is something we can expect from her moving forward. Finally, I want to talk about the incoming freshman class for the Huskies, featuring most notably AZ Fudd and Caroline Duchami. Fudd is a lights out shooter and one of the top players in her class. The prospect of her and Paige becoming a duo is exciting to me, as AZ can be a legitimate second option behind Paige, something the Huskies lacked a lot of last season. Secondary scorers behind Paige weren't always consistent, so to have a bona fide second star with her, who, by the way, is a player Paige already has heaps of chemistry with, is going to do plenty of positive things for UConn. Fudd has freshman of the year potential, so assuming she makes the most of her minutes, she's going to be a brilliant addition to UConn that keeps them in the hunt for a national championship. Duchami, which I'm hoping I'm pronouncing correctly, is a player I've followed for a little while in high school, and she also joins AZ Fudd as a top 5 ranked player in their respective class. It's not every day that a program gets a Gatorade State Player of the Year, but also not every day that the said program could get such a player and have them be considered the second best player of the incoming class. That speaks volumes of the levels of talent coming into the Husky system in 2022 in Fudd and Duchami. Duchami will add further depth to the already stacked backcourt of the Huskies. It's been reported in practice that she's already making her talents known that should see her end up with a sizable role for next season. That's a great sign for an already young Huskies team ready to make some immediate noise. Overall, these two freshmen are going to be extremely exciting to watch. And again, considering how they're both top 5 players in their class, to join an already highly talented Huskies team just makes it seem, at least on paper, that UConn should be favourites for the national championship going into 2022. So those are all the players that I want to talk about today. Obviously, there's a few more that'll make an impact, such as Avena Westbrook, but those are the players I wanted to key in on today. But what else makes this Huskies team so special? And why does it give me so much belief in them? Well, the one thing that you'll notice about this roster and its core of players is it's a relatively young team, quite a bit younger than other top 10 ranked teams in the NCAA, which to me is an advantage. This group will have a lot of hunger to get to the top. Paige proves that every time she steps on the court, and she lifts her teammates in that manner. They've spoken heavily about the heartbreak of 2021, so it's no doubt going to motivate them to get back to the top. It's an exciting time for Huskies fans, as this group looks set to go for another deep run come March. Another reason why I'm very confident in UConn is because of what happened to the other top teams around them. Just to name a few, Baylor lost their head coach, who was instrumental to their program and also suffered losses of Dede Richards and others to the WNBA. Arizona, the team to upset UConn, lost Ari McDonald as she declared for the WNBA draft, and other powerhouses like Tennessee just don't stack up the same anymore. To me, the biggest competition and biggest threat to the Huskies' championship chances is South Carolina, who are also running it back with two of the top 10 players in the class of 2021. Add into the mix the return of Zaire Cook and Aaliyah Boston to the program, two cold-blooded scorers and offensive weapons in their own right, the Gamecocks look very legit. With that said though, I just feel more confident in the Huskies. They're a young, hungry team who are desperate to taste the championship glory, and to me, at least on paper, have a deeper roster. The battle between the two sides though would be amazing, and I think it could go either way, like last season. But with UConn to me just looking even stronger than last year, I think I'd favour them right now. Finally, one of the biggest reasons why I think the Huskies are the favorites for the national championship in 2022 is because of their coach, Gino Auriemma. When you have a coach of his caliber with his experience and success, you know the team can go a long way, even with inexperience overall. Look at the group last season. That's a team led by a freshman. Like, I mean, for them to reach the Final Four is pretty incredible. There's no doubt Auriemma has played an enormous role in the Huskies' success, and that will continue into 2022, and potentially provide UConn a competitive advantage in those tight chess match games against other top sides. But overall, these are my thoughts on the UConn Huskies. With a coach like Gino Auriemma and a player like Paige Bueckers, it's hard to ignore this team as a contender. But add into the fact the players they are returning and the type of talents they have coming in through the freshman class, it's hard to deny that this team is one of the favorites to win it all. UConn seems absolutely loaded and with a desire to go far. It's not hard to have some confidence in this team. I'm hyped for the new NCAA season. It's going to be a whole lot of fun, and I can't wait to see how Paige Bueckers and the Huskies go as they look to redeem themselves from their Final Four exit a few months ago. We'll have to wait and see what happens, but right now, looking at this young Huskies team, I have to say they are my favorites to win it all next season. And that will conclude the video. What do you guys think of this? How good are the UConn Huskies to you? Can they go all the way in 2022? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to drop it a like and subscribe. But with that being said, I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.